Greetings and blessings. What a blessing it is to be able to serve the Lord today. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to our worship on Zoom Live. Announcements. Please remember that Monday and Thursday at 11 o'clock is our gospel-seated physical exercise led by Tess Morton. And if you haven't participated with us, we ask that you would register with Joyce Floyd, Sister Joyce Floyd, and everyone is welcome to join us. On Monday at 7 o'clock p.m. is our official board meeting on Zoom. We invite you to join us in our regular meeting time and meeting space for official board. Wednesday at 12 noon and 6 o'clock p.m. will be the pastor's Bible study. Come join us as we study the seven churches of Asia Minor. We enjoy your presence, and we thank God for your participation in our Bible study. On August the 23rd is our 200th church anniversary. Sister Bessie Jackson, the coordinator and chairperson, will give you more information later on. And the Right Reverend Jeffrey Nathaniel Leith will be our preacher for that morning. We want to congratulate Brother and Sister George and Tamara Terry as they celebrate their 12th wedding anniversary today. We want to say God bless you, and may you have many more anniversaries. Thank you. We hope you govern yourselves accordingly to the announcements.
Good morning. Please join us on August the 16th at 11 a.m. as we celebrate Pastor's Appreciation Day in honor of Reverend Strode and First Lady Shelby Strode. More information will be coming out through our class leaders. If you have any additional questions, please contact any of the steward board members. Thank you. Good morning.
Please remember to pray for our known sick and shut in, our Sister Paulette Coleman, Sister Lizzie Connor, Sister Marion Dunn, Brother Maurice Dunn, Reverend Barry Frazier, Brother John Fullwood, Sister Lillian Gentry, Sister Carolyn Higgins, Sister Marjorie Johnson, Sister Nancy Miller, Sister Anna Walker, Sister Joanne White, Sister Viola White, Sister Wanda Thomas, and also be in prayer for the Gentry family as Brother Jerry Gentry will be funeralized on Tuesday at 12:30 at Smith & Smith Funeral Home, and visitation for the public will be from 11 to 12:30, and the private funeral service will be at 12:30. The Reverend Gaines will be the officiator, and I will be the one to do the eulogy. So we encourage you to be in prayer for the Gentry family. God bless you. We love you, and govern yourselves accordingly. Amen. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem.
For a day in thy court is better than a thousand. I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of the wickedness.
Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good.
Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
Blessed are they that dwell in thy house, Lord. I have loved the habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth.
For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
O sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all the earth, and sing praises.
Let us sing together more about Jesus. More about Jesus would I know, more of his grace to others show, more of his saving fullness see, more of his love who died for me. And we do not own the rights to this music. Morning prayer will be led by Brother Myron Coleman.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, we come this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts that you woke us up early this morning one more time. We thank you, Heavenly Father, because you're an awesome God. Mm-hmm. You have been so good to us. You have turned our midnights into day.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, we ask that as we come this morning, God, we come humbly to this throne of grace, God, because you're just everything that we need. You've supplied everything that we need. Heavenly Father, today is a new day.
Yes.
It's a day, God, that if we haven't got it right, we can get it right. Heavenly Father, we ask that you bless us, Lord, in this service. Mm-hmm. And even though we can't come together as a people, as your people. We're thankful, God, for what you have provided for us to worship you still. Mm-hmm. Heavenly Father, you are so mighty. You are so much that, Heavenly Father, we just don't even understand what you do sometimes. God, we ask that you continue to supply our needs.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, bless those, Heavenly Father, who are weak in spirit, those who are sick, those who are institutionalized, even our church members, Heavenly Father. We ask, God, that you, those that are sick, that you bless them, bless our church, Heavenly Father, as we prepare to celebrate 200 years, yes. As we work towards that, Heavenly Father, be with us. We know, God, that you're God who's able to do everything. And God, we're just so humble, Lord, that and thankful that what you have done for us, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, keep us now as we continue in this service.
Yes.
And that our service might lift you up a little bit higher.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Heavenly Father, we need you.
Oh, Jesus.
In these troubled times, Lord, you're the only one we can look to. We give you the honor, praise, and glory, Heavenly Father, for all things. Bless our pastor as he leads us.
Yes.
And in the name of Jesus, we pray and we ask it all. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. God bless you. He is Lord. Old Testament reading will be read by Exhorter Shelby G. Strode.
I shall read 1 Kings, the 19th chapter, 9 through 18 verses. There he went into a cave and spent the night. And the word of the Lord came to him, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" He replied, "I have been very zealous for the Lord God Almighty. The Israelites have rejected your covenant, torn down your altars, and put your prophets to death with a sword. I am the only one left, and now they're trying to kill me too." The Lord said, "Go out and stand on the mountain in the presence of the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by." Then a great and powerful wind tore the mountains apart and shattered the rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake came a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire came a gentle whisper. When Elijah heard it, he pulled his cloak over his face and went out and stood at the mouth of the cave. Then a voice said to him, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" He replied, "I have been very zealous for the Lord God Almighty. The Israelites have rejected your covenant, torn down your altars, and put your prophets to death with a sword. I am the only one left, and now they're trying to kill me too." The Lord said to him, "Go back the way you came and go to the desert of Damascus. When you get there, anoint Hazael, king over Aram. Also anoint Jehu, son of Nimshi, king over Israel. And anoint Elijah, son of Shaphat, from Abel-Mahola. to succeed you as prophet. Jehu will put to death any who escaped the sword of Hazael, and Elijah will put to death any who escaped the sword of Jehu. Yet I reserve 7,000 in Israel, all whose knees have not bowed down to Baal, and those mouths have not kissed him. I've read from the New International Version, the word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Amen. The epistle reading will be read by Sister Monica Lamb.
Good morning. I will be reading from Romans 10, 5 through 15. For Moses writes that the law's way of making a person right with God requires obedience to all of its commands. But faith's way of getting right with God says, don't say in your heart, who will go up to heaven to bring Christ down to earth? And don't say, who will go down to the place of the dead to bring Christ back to life again? In fact, it says the message is very close at hand. It is on your lips and in your heart. And that message is the very message about faith that we preach. If you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by believing in your heart that you made, it is by believing in your heart that you are made right with Christ. And it is by openly declaring your faith that you will be, you are saved. All as the scripture tells us, anyone who trusts in him will never be disgraced. Jew and Gentile are the same in this respect. They have the same Lord who gives generously to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. But how can they call on him to save them unless they believe in him? And how can they believe in him if they never heard about him? And how can they hear about him unless someone tells them? And how will anyone go and tell without being sent? That is why scripture says, how beautiful are the feet of messengers who bring the good news. May God continue to add a blessing unto his word.
Amen. The gospel reading will be read by Exhorter Doris Jean Coffey.
Hit star 6 on your phone, Doris.
Immediately after this, Jesus insisted that his disciples get back into the boat and cross to the other side of the lake while he sent the people home. After sending them home, he went up into the hills by himself to pray. Night fell while he was there alone. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from land, for a strong wind had risen and they were fighting heavy waves. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came toward them walking on the water. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified. In their fear, they cried out, "It's a ghost!" But Jesus spoke to them at once. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Take courage. I am here." Then Peter called to him, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you, walking on the water." "Yes, come," Jesus said. So Peter went over the side of the boat and walked on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and began to sink. "Save me, Lord," he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. "You have so little faith," Jesus said. "Why did you doubt me?" When they climbed back into the boat, the wind stopped. Then the disciples worshiped him. "You really are the Son of God," they exclaimed. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of God's holy word for the edification of God's church.
Amen.
The summary of the Decalogue. Reverend Foster.
From all that dwell below the skies.
said to them, you should love the Lord thy God with all of thy heart, with all of thy soul, and with all of thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Waiting on Jesus by the Williams Brothers. We do not own the rights to this music.
Oh, oh, oh. I'm just waiting on Jesus. Lord, I'm gonna wait because my waiting days will soon be over. Oh, yes, there is.
Sitting here waiting,
Jesus.
Oh yes, I am.
Lord, I'm gonna wait because my waiting days will soon be over. Oh yes, they will. You know, sometimes my waiting
seems
dark.
Yes,
Waiting days will soon be over. Oh, yes, they will.
You know that sharing you their strength. Anybody ever wait on morning. Let me see waiting hand. Keep waiting. Keep on waiting. Keep on, keep on waiting. Keep on, keep on waiting. I'm gonna wait.
Gonna wait on you.
Oh Lord,
yes.
On Jesus. Amen. Yes, amen. Amen. The officer of the day is Sister Jean Coleman, and she will lead us in an offering.
This is the time during worship you can participate by giving. You can give using the following methods. Check our credit card, by phone, by calling the church at 859-255-7945. Leaving your name and number, and the finance team will return your call. Visit the church website at spam.org, then select donate and click on tithes and offering. If you have set up your account on Breeze, then you can give through Breeze by following the link on the church website, Breeze Church Membership. Or finally, text giving by dialing 859-209-6003. Donations can also be mailed to the church address at 251 North Upper Street, Lexington, Kentucky, 40507. Remember, we are asking each member to give $1 for every year toward our 200th church anniversary, held on August 23rd, for a total of $200. We gladly appreciate you and thank you.
Amen. All things come of thee, O Lord. The sermonic selection is "The Battle Is Not Yours" by Yolanda Adams, and we do not own the rights to this music.
All things work.
God be praised. God be praised. Let us pray. Father God, as we come before your presence, we come with thanksgiving, recognizing, God, that you are in control. And we look for you for guidance and direction. And now, God, we know it's time to hear the word of God. Speak through your preacher that the people might hear. For when you speak, souls are saved. Mm-hmm. When you speak, those of us who are saved are deepened in the faith. And God, we will always be careful to give you the praise.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
We honor God who's the head of our lives, and yes, to First Lady Shelby Strode.
God bless you.
To our ministerial staff, to our officers and members, and to those of you who are joining us on Zoom, we thank God for you and what you mean to St. Paul Church. We are so elated to have another opportunity to worship God. And
yes,
as we worship God, we want to worship God in spirit, mm-hmm, and in truth.
Oh, yes.
I want to look at 1 Kings, the 19th chapter and the 13th verse as the text. Mm-hmm. And it reads, when Elijah heard it, he pulled his cloak over his face, mm-hmm, and went out and stood at the mouth of the cave. Then a voice said to him, what are you doing here, Elijah? Last Sunday, I talked about holding on to God.
Oh, yes.
When Jacob wrestled with a man until daybreak. Today, I want to talk about listen to God, because God wants to encourage you.
Yes.
Listen to God, mm-hmm, because God wants to encourage you. Elijah is a very important figure in how to deal with COVID-19, mm-hmm, and any other calamity.
All right.
Or any other kind of pandemic. You see, Elijah was told by God to go to Mount Carmel.
All right.
And a showdown would take place on Mount Carmel between God and Baal. And in that showdown, Elijah did what God told him to do.
Oh, yes.
And in that story, the Israelites were serving Baal with Jezebel.
My Lord.
But God used Elijah to prove that God was God.
All right, preacher.
And after that episode on Mount Carmel, Elijah fled because Jezebel and all of her prophets were out to kill him.
Lord Jesus.
A message came to Elijah and said to Elijah, I want you to know that Jezebel is after you and she's going to kill you.
Oh, Jesus.
Elijah fled from Jezebel, mm-hmm, and went to another part of the place where the Mount Carmel situation took place. And he took refuge under a juniper tree. I want you to see this clearly, because sometimes when you have a high moment, Elijah had a high moment.
Yes.
He had called down God's glory upon the people where they could see that God was God. Uh-huh. And now Elijah has become estranged from God, because he saw the enemy coming after him. Mm-hmm. He saw more of Jezebel and her prophets than he saw in God.
My God.
He got under the juniper tree in depression.
Yes.
And fell asleep. And the Bible says that an angel came and woke him up and told him to eat, because the journey has become more in tune to what you need to do. Sometimes when you're going through things,
come on,
you'll find yourselves at a point where you don't want to eat. You get so depressed because you don't know what direction to go in.
Well,
but God knows all about us.
Yes.
He knows what we need even before we ask.
Yes.
Look at what the angel tells him to eat. You need your strength for the journey.
Yes.
The Bible says he ate and then he went back to sleep.
Yes.
When you are depressed, even though you are depressed, God still speaks to you. But you got to listen to God.
Yes.
Because God wants to encourage you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, while Elijah is sleeping, the second time, the angel comes to him and tells him to rise and eat. And he eats. And the angel tells him that he has a journey that he needs to take.
Mm-hmm.
Elijah is still depressed. And the Bible says he journeys to a cave at the setting of the text for today.
Oh, yes.
While sitting under the juniper tree, he goes into a cave and he's more depressed.
My God.
You see, that's how we are. God will speak to us,
mm-hmm.
and we just won't listen.
Ooh, Jesus.
Sometimes we get so depressed, we miss our blessings because we're looking at our depression more than our blessing.
That's the truth.
So Elijah is in this cave. And while he's in that cave, the Bible says that something happened.
Mm-hmm.
God spoke to him, and he didn't realize what was happening.
My Lord.
When you see in the 19th verse, it says, so he departed thence and found Elisha.
Yes.
That's the end of what happened while he was in the cave.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you see? Some of our problem exists because we don't listen to God.
Ooh, that's the truth.
Some of our problems that we have are directly related to us not listening to God. And all God wants to do is to encourage us.
Yes, Lord.
While he's in the cave,
come on, Pastor.
The Bible says that it says, go forth and stand upon the mount before the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind rent the mountains,
yes,
and break in pieces the rocks before the Lord.
Uh-huh.
In other words, Elijah was in the cave still depressed.
Yes.
He had not moved from the juniper tree to the point of relief in the mountain.
Come on, Pastor.
Because you see, in the mountain, while he was in that cave, and the cave is emblematic of one who is depressed,
yes,
one who has withdrawn, one who has gone into hiding.
Uh-huh.
Elijah was gone into hiding.
Well,
and while he's in hiding, God comes by and yes, gets his attention. There was a great wind.
Preach.
And there was a great earthquake.
Preach.
There was a great fire.
Yeah, yeah.
And God was not in any of that, mm-hmm. but it was a commotion to get his attention.
Yes.
And when God got his attention, he spoke to him.
Preach.
Not in the wind, not in the earth,
yes.
quake, not in the fire,
preach, Pastor.
Not in the commotion of earthly things happening. It was only to get his attention.
Yes.
And when it got his attention, he hid his face because no one, as you saw last Sunday, saw the face of God and lived. Elijah heard God in a small, still voice.
Yes.
And he wants to speak to you today in a small, still voice.
Yes.
He wants your attention.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And
when
he gets Jesus. Your attention, he speaks to you.
Yes, he does.
You hear what God said to him?
Hmm.
He said, Elijah, what are you doing here? Why are you here?
My God.
And the question to you today is, during this COVID-19 situation, do you believe that God is bringing us through this?
Yes, he is.
That he wants us to know that he's with us. And if we listen to God,
preach, Pastor,
God will direct us in how to deal with this pandemic.
Yes, he will.
Don't be afraid. Just be cautious and concerned that you are doing the things that God has spoken to you to do.
That's it.
If you were talking to a friend and never stopped talking, you will never hear your friend. You got to always listen to God, who is your friend.
That's right.
He wants you to know that I just want you to hear me.
That's right.
And if you listen, he's saying, I will encourage you.
Yes, he will.
A lot of the things can get in our way of listening. Many times we become too busy. We become so wrapped up into us.
Come on, preacher.
That we miss what God is saying.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's through our schoolwork. Sometimes we put more emphasis on our schoolwork than we do our work for God.
Lord Jesus.
Sometimes it's sports. Sometimes it's extracurricular activity. Sometimes it's family duties that we put before God.
Help us, Lord.
And sometimes it's community service, thinking that we're serving God when we really gratifying our own emotions.
Ooh, Jesus.
Well, when God spoke to Elijah in that mountain, and when God got his attention, he caused something to happen that should happen to all of us. It's not in the commotion of things that's happening.
That's it.
It's getting in the presence of God. Elijah got out of the presence of God when he went under the juniper tree and began to focus on his enemy.
Oh, Jesus.
Rather than the God that will carry him through.
Yes.
Elijah got out of the presence of God when he went into the cave and stayed in the cave. And it wasn't until God got his attention that he was able to listen to God. If you're not listening to God today, I encourage you to listen. He has a word of encouragement for you. The Lord will never leave you nor forsake you. The Lord will carry you through whatever you're going through. Just trust him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So in a gentle whisper.
Yes, Lord.
God spoke to Elijah, and Elijah was in a situation where he heard God clearly. Elijah was feeling the stress
Yes, Lord.
Of ministry.
Oh, God.
And persecution.
My God.
Many of us today are experiencing the feeling of stress of ministry and persecution.
That's the truth.
As a Christian, your ministry is under attack. As a Christian, you're going through things that you don't even recognize, and God wants you to listen.
That's right.
To what he's saying, because he wants to encourage you.
Yes, Lord.
God told him to enter into my presence. Mm-hmm. When we hit hard times,
come on, Pastor.
We need to go into God's presence and know that God will reveal God's self to us, just like he did for Elijah. I don't know what you're going through.
Come on, Pastor.
But there's one thing that I do know.
Yes.
That if you listen to God,
yeah.
He will encourage your heart.
Yes, he will.
Not only will he cut your heart, he'll tell you what to do and how to do it.
Yes.
When you trust him. He'll carry you to where you need to know.
Yes, yes.
And go.
Yes.
You see, we see God approaching this mountain. There was this great commotion that got Elijah's attention. Mm-hmm. What commotion is getting your attention?
Ooh.
I suggest to you, COVID-19 is the commotion.
Oh, Jesus.
It has upset and has derailed many of our expectations of the church and what the church ought to be. But I'm here to tell you that when you listen to God, God will direct your path. And as you listen to him, you'll understand if you acknowledge him in all things, he will direct your path.
Yes, he will.
So you see, we have to help ourselves to understand from this story.
Yes, Lord.
That when you wait on Jesus, he will help you to know how to listen to God, because God wants to encourage you. And you know the battle's not yours.
That's right.
It is the Lord.
That's right.
And he's getting us ready. For in the gospel reading, you saw where Jesus was in the boat and told Peter to come out and walk on the water. And it was his faith that Jesus questioned. And he told him, as long as your faith is directed in me, then you can walk on water.
Yes,
as long as you keep your faith on the Lord Jesus Christ, he'll give you the strength. And now I'm about ready to go. And when you get yourself together, and you listen to what the Lord has said, there's nothing that can stop you. Great is he that's in you than he that's in the world. When you start listening to God, watch how God encourages you. I don't care how dark it looks. I don't care how frustrating things might be. When you trust in the Lord and believe that the Lord will carry you through, watch him carry you through. And when he carries you through, it'll cause you to think about what's given me my faith at the cross. At the cross.
Yes.
Where I first saw the light.
Yes.
And the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight. And now I am happy all the day. And yes. Early Sunday morning, Jesus got up out of the grave.
Yes.
And declared all power in heaven and earth.
Yes, he did.
In his hand.
Oh, Jesus.
And because we listen to God, we'll know that God wants to encourage us.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
My baby sister said, I like to hear, I need you now. And I said, well, that would be a good invitation for my message today. Somebody today, you're going through something. You know that you've been trying to listen to God, but there's been too much commotion around you.
Yes.
I suggest to you, that God wants to get you ready for his great getting up morning.
Yes, Lord.
If you haven't accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, we invite you to give your life to him. Or if you're new to the city and you're looking for a church home, we welcome you. Or if you just need prayer, you can call the church at 859-255-7945. Or you can call the pastor at 502-330-1815. Mm-hmm. I Need You Now by Smokey Norfolk. And the invitation is extended to you. I'm excited, y'all.
Amen.
The Lord has blessed us.
Yes.
And you ought to give your life to Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
I need you now.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless you.
Not a second or another minute, not an hour, another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door,
the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven and seated on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he should come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. And the people said, Amen. God bless you. Thank you for worshiping with us live. We love you.